Okay, you're in Microsoft Word and you want to know how to add footnotes and or endnotes. Now, footnotes appear at the bottom of the page where the footnote is referred to, and endnotes appear at the end of the document. So let's look at how to add a footnote to begin with. I'm going to place my first footnote reference at the end of this paragraph. So my flashing cursor is in that position. I go to the References tab on the ribbon, and in the Footnotes group, I've got this button here, Insert Footnote. I can also use this shortcut key, Alt-Control-F, but I'm just going to click on the button. Now, as soon as you do that, it takes you to the bottom of that page, and you can see it's entered the number 1, because this is the first footnote that I've created within this document. So to keep things simple, I'm just going to write some placeholder text, footnote 1. Now, you can insert as many footnotes as you like within a page. So if I click here at the end of the second paragraph, I could add another footnote. Now, the great thing about footnotes is that if I change the order of this content, so for example, if I put this paragraph before what was the first paragraph, you can see that it's renumbered the footnotes. So this used to be a 2, and this used to be a 1. If I look down here now, footnote 1 has the text footnote 2, and vice versa. So these footnotes automatically update in terms of their numbering. Now, to insert an endnote, you do almost the same thing. Place your cursor where you want the endnote reference to be positioned, and then you click on this button, Insert Endnote, and that'll take you to the end of the document. I'll just write some placeholder text. Now, what you can do is convert all footnotes to endnotes or vice versa. You can do that by clicking on this little launcher button in the footnotes group. And if I click on this convert button, you can see I have these options: convert all footnotes to endnotes, convert all endnotes to footnotes, or swap footnotes and endnotes. Well, I want all footnotes, so I'm going to go for this middle option here. Click on OK and then close. And you can see now I have all of those what are now footnotes at the bottom of page 1. Now, I have created a more detailed video tutorial on footnotes and endnotes, and I'll leave a link to that video in the description of this video. Okay, that's all I wanted to cover. Hopefully that's been useful. If it has, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe, and I'll see you next video.